Hi, I'm Hannah from Planet Tuna, and I'm delighted to present this masterclass in scientific illustration of a fish with Pedro Salgado, a fabulous illustrator I've been following for years. Pedro's from Lisbon. He's a marine biologist and a professor of scientific illustration. And in the last 30 years, he's trained a whole new generation of scientific illustrators in Portugal. His works appeared in many publications and even on stamps in his native country. In this first video, we'll see how Pedro studies all the details of the fish in order to do a preliminary drawing in pencil with help from photographer and filmmaker Steve Stower. And then this preliminary illustration will be the basis for what he does in the second video, which is the final black and white illustration in ink. Pedro and Steve love art, and they also love a good adventure, so they didn't hesitate to come to Mallorca and get on a fishing boat at the crack of dawn in order to be able to observe a bluefin tuna the moment that it's brought out of the water, which is a unique experience.
When I start an illustration of a fish, the first thing I need is to look at good references. Sometimes I have to draw from preserved specimens with damaged fins and missing parts, which requires many hours of work to reconstruct on my preliminary drawings every structure that is important to identify the species. But today I'm feeling lucky. I'll have the opportunity to observe and touch a perfect tuna. I'm looking for the outline of each fin ray of the second dorsal fin with these interruptions here, and then follow these almost invisible lines to reconstruct them so we can clearly see the number and shape of each single ray in my drawings. We can see that the pectoral fin fits perfectly inside the cavity of the body. The surface is evenly covered when the fin retracts. In this photo, I can also see the point where the second dorsal fin starts. Here, I can see all the rays of the first dorsal. This hidden part, I'll get it in the next photo on the left. Because the tuna is lying flat, the weight of the body is deforming it. Here, it's hanging in order to avoid the deformation. We can see that in the photo taken aboard, below, the head is shorter. The best photos of each one of the parts are mounted all at the same scale on top of the entire body of the hanging tuna, which has the correct proportions. Each fin is printed separately. It is necessary to consult scientific publications to check all the features for identification, in particular the position and shape of each fin with its number of spines and soft rays. We must also pay attention to the structures and visible bones of the head, the body shape, lateral line, and pigmentation patterns. The drawing process starts from the interpretation of the photos. Some structures are almost invisible and must be captured with scientific accuracy. The lines are drawn first with a marker on transparent acetate to clearly see all the details of the photo, and then on tracing paper with sharpened graphite pencils and erasers to correct and define all the contour lines. Several copies reduced to 50% were made on tracing paper and on drawing paper to be used for the next preliminary studies at the same scale of the final illustration. From now on, I'll be working on the study that will be my main reference for the final art in ink, using graphite pencils on the smooth drawing paper previously printed out with all the outlines, so I can easily work on my tonal study in progress, drawing and erasing over it without ever losing the reference lines. Before starting to work on the final illustration, it's very important to spend a considerable amount of time working on detailed and accurate preliminary studies. It is during these studies that all the morphological features for the identification of the species are represented in its definitive forms, as well as all the tonal values for the representation of the volumes and pigmentation patterns. Thank you. Soon, I'll be ready to start the final illustration in pen and ink.